On today's show, we're going to hunt whitetail deer in Alabama at Ron's property he calls Karma. The property's under a whitetail deer management program by the state of Alabama, so we're going to see what we can do about enforcing that program.
Any day in the woods with a firearm in your hand is better than a day behind the desk.
Jerry, if it looks like I'm going to get gored, put around in me, would you?
I was thinking if they come at this, I'm going to trip you. How can you have all these hills without valleys, huh?
Nice shot. Good bird.
Oh, look at that now.
I want you to come out in your loincloth and me with a rifle. I'll think it's a white bear.
In the Woods with Ron and Jerry is brought to you by Envirologic of Alabama, products that make sense for you and your environment. By Landis International, there is no substitute for perfection. By NPP Incorporated, flying Ron and Jerry to the next day in the woods. By the 500 Magnum Energy Bar, power for now, power for later. And by Karma LLC, an elevated state of awareness.
I bought my first piece of property in Alabama in 1989. I now have four pieces in the same general area, Wilcox and Marengo and Lowndes County. And I've started deer hunting and managing deer from the very beginning. The state assists with this program, and they advise every year how many does you're supposed to take out and the limitations on the bucks that you're supposed to shoot.
Have you succeeded in getting those every year, the numbers that they recommend, or has that been a tough thing to do?
It's been really tough, Jerry. In fact, I don't think that we've ever taken out the complete number of does that they want me to take out, which is usually around 30 off of the home property.
And the property is 1,500 acres?
1,500 acres.
Okay. All right. Well, let's give it a try and see how many we can take this year.
Yep. I hope we can continue because our doe size and the general health of the population, the size of our bucks, it's gotten better almost every year.
In addition to the does, I know we looked at some trail cam photos. We have some bucks on there that need to be taken from the herd. We don't want them breeding, some cull bucks.
Right. This is not like a place where you go and they have a really strong genetics. I mean, this is just another place in the Alabama woods, and we have some deer with some ugly racks.
Well,
we've been taking them out for 20 years. There's fewer of them today, but they're still there.
Well, we need to get the rest of them, so let's see what we can do about getting a few more of them out of here.
You know, historically speaking, Jerry, we have never been able to kill any deer until I've sharpened the knives from the previous hunt.
You should sharpen every time then.
a friend of mine used to say, if you're going to handle knives, you're going to cut yourself. And if you cut yourself with a sharp blade, it'll heal a lot faster than if it's rugged.
So a lot better off.
Ragged.
Right.
Yeah, so let's always keep your knife sharp, then you'll heal faster. It's kind of a negative way of looking at it.
Well, negative motivation is better than no motivation.
That's it. We're ready to kill another one now.
When you finish this, why don't we look at some trail cam pictures?
Hey, that's a good idea.
Okay, we got some still photos that were printed out from the trail cam. We could do that, or we could pull a computer in here.
Let's take a look at those. We've got some ugly deer. We need to get off this place if we can.
I saw them around here this morning. Wait, I think this is the folder right here. Let's see what we got for trail cam pictures. I got some up here from the shots. Take a look at this guy. Let's double click on him.
This is that really, really, that's an old.
That's stuff. That old buck, yeah.
I've never seen a spike that is that old.
Yeah, that's an old deer, boy.
Right. This is the one that Mitch named Neptune.
Oh, yeah, he called
it. He has got to go.
Boy, yeah, look at that thing. That's just
man, this is an old timer, too.
Yeah, I think they call that one the Roman, huh?
Do you suppose that's genetics, or do you think that might be?
I think he might have got injured in a fight or something. It looks like his nose is all swollen. Looks like my nose. You know, I broke mine 9 times in my life.
Well, if you'd pay more attention to what your wife tells you to do, it probably wouldn't be so bad. You know, I never realized, but you do have a big swollen beak.
Most of them were playing basketball. I used to think I was 6'4". I like to bang underneath. And my height, I'm right at the 6'4 guy's elbows, you know.
Yeah, I understand.
I had a lot of breaks there playing basketball, but it was fun then.
They made me quit playing basketball because I was too high a scorer.
Too high a score?
And
yeah.
They just
kept dunking the ball.
No one would play with me.
Right.
So
I can understand why they made you quit.
There's another one.
What is wrong with that deer?
I mean, there's a lot wrong with that deer.
My goodness. Look at that mess on his head.
Well, that's enough looking. Let's go out for the afternoon hunt.
Good idea. Right. Let's put this away, put the electronics away, and get the weapons out and see what we can do today.
Yeah. We hadn't been in the stand for a couple of minutes and deer started jumping across the road. I didn't have a chance at the first couple, but I got the rifle up in time to get a round off on the third one.
Oh, we've got a nice doe down up here, and that's what we're out here for. This is time of year we're trying to thin down the does. So we're going to go up and take a look at that animal.
Oh, this is a nice looking doe. It's exactly what we're looking for this time of the year. State recommendation is that we take 30 animals off of 30 does off of this property this year, and it's been slow hunting. Been a little bit warmer after a cold snap earlier in the season when we saw all kinds of deer, and now it's really slowed down a lot. But this young lady came out on us this morning. Let's take a look, see if she doesn't have milk. So she's either weaned her youngsters or lost them earlier in the year to predators. This is a nice looking deer. I'd say it's going to go 100, 105 pounds, which is typical for a mature doe around here.
Well, Ron had a successful morning, but can't say the same for Mitch and I. We sat around and watched squirrels all morning. So we went in and made a game plan. And we decided to try to get out early in the afternoon and see if we can catch some of these bucks in the field early.
I'm gonna take a shot. Okay, go ahead.
We're coming into the field that we plan to hunt this afternoon. Took the bad boy so we could be quiet, and sure enough, just as we got on the edge of the field, we were about 50 yards from the stand. One of the bucks that we've been seeing on the trail camera, one of the management bucks, is standing in the field grazing. I was able to get a shot off at him. Mitch didn't have time to get the tripod out. He handheld the camera. It may be a little wobbly, but he handheld the camera, got the shot on camera, and we got one of those management bucks down that Ron wants to get out of here. We haven't even reached the stand yet that we were planning to get to hunt out of this afternoon. It's coming up on our right now. This is exactly what we were looking for. This is one of the bucks on Ron's hit list. He's got a spike on the right side and a main beam on the left side. It's about 7 inches long, broke off, got one little nub on it. Got him out of the herd now. He won't be breeding any of Ron's does, so this is just a perfect example of what we need to get out of here. Well, we got us a buck, one of the ones on the hit list. Now we gotta go back and clean him. That's the only nasty part. That's kind of a labor of love. We enjoy that kind of stuff. When we get one of these kind of bucks out of the herd, that's what we need to do. So that'll just make the herd a lot better in the future.
After giving my favorite stand a couple days rest, we went back. Once again, it was a cold and foggy morning. And once again, it wasn't long before we had deer crossing the road.
Not where the crow is. There's another one. See it?
That's a
about 200 yards down there. Let's see if I can, it'll come out. Yeah. Oh boy, that's a good shot. Well, she's down. Let's go down there and... I always like to save my lucky brass. Let's go down there and see what we've got, Mitch. I gotta lose some weight. This is a perfect deer. This is just what we're looking for. I'm gonna go get the vehicle and come and pick her up. Come on, sweetheart. We just recently started using trail cameras on Carmen. On the way back in, we decided to stop and pull a card, see what might have come through last night.
This segment of In the Woods with Ron and Jerry has been brought to you by Landis International.
I've been hunting with Ron for 20 years on this property, and I don't think I've ever been here for a month and not seen anything. I think in the whole time I was here, I saw one deer, that one cull buck, which I was lucky enough to get, and I was losing my mind. And this is what happens when you hunt for a month and don't see anything except the guy that's videoing you the whole time.
I think I'm delirious.
You think you're delirious?
I'm sure I'm delirious.
Why is that?
Because I think I see a deer. I'm beginning to enjoy myself. But I've always enjoyed myself. But I usually don't share that with anybody. Bong cuckoo, bong cuckoo.
The chisel she zizzle and the dogs and the hogs and the mogs and the hogs.
Let me get the hat off for Mitch.
Go ahead
and here's Mitch.
This is his earring, I don't have one. Bane. Come on, here's Ron. Well, I have killed 100 deer today. And if I could get one more, I'll be happy. Haven't got the big one yet, but I know he's out there. And here's Ty. Yeah, okay, we'll do Jerry. My, I'm having a good time. Yeah, I don't know what to do next. In fact, I won't do anything like I've been doing for the last month.
You gotta start snoring, though.
Those weren't snores.
Now, all of you hunters out there have been on those kind of hunts where you just go out and you can't win for losing. Well, that's the way it had been for Jerry. He was starting to go over the edge after hunting for a couple of weeks and not even seeing a deer. We bought a piece of property up in Lowndes County. That's the next county sort of northeast of here. And we went up there early in the year and set up a box. Since we hadn't been seeing many deer here on the home property, we decided to go up there and give it a try.
We've got three properties that are removed from Karma in Wilcox County, in Lowndes County, and Marengo County, not too far away from the home farm. We're up here in Lowndes today on one of our green fields that we've put in. We haven't spent a lot of time up here. Our objective is to harvest any call bucks that we might see, and also any does to thin the doe population down. The most important objective though today is to get any of the call bucks that we might see before the breeding season hits full force. Call bucks out onto the field. We have got to get this one out of the herd.
Well, I had a good shot at this deer, but the camera couldn't see it. Then the camera had good visual on the deer, and I couldn't see it. Then it finally got out where the camera could see the deer, and I could see the deer, and a doe was right behind it.
Safety is off. When the doe moves, I'm going to call fire and then I'll shoot.
Closed captioning for this program has been brought to you by Envirologic of Alabama, products that make sense.
We thought this was never going to happen. Finally, the doe started to walk off.
Fire one, fire two.
I can't believe he moved.
I really thought I'd put a perfect shot on that deer and expected him to drop straight down, but he ran off the field to the side. I'm expecting to find him right in the woods, but of course that's never a guarantee. We're going to go down. We've given him a few minutes here. Now we're going to go down and hopefully be able to find him pretty quickly.
Right around in here. Oh, right here we've got really, there's some more really good blood. Yeah, we've got a really good blood trail going here. Whew. I was worried a little bit about that. I'm not used to having them run when I take a shot. Yeah. He's not as ugly as he was. What do we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We wanted to get off the property. We're wearing ourselves out down at Karma and wanted to go up to one of the satellite properties. We've got three of them. This one is off to the northeast, a fairly small place. And we took the objective of we were going to shoot does, we were going to shoot calls, and we were going to shoot trophy bucks. This call buck won today. He may not have been a call genetically, but we have no way of knowing that. This side, he's got a lot of mass, but this side may have been damaged when he was in velvet, or this may just be a genetic abnormality. Irrespective, it's very, very typical for Lowndes County or Wilcox County deer, and he won't be breeding any of our does this year.
Went up to Fernum tonight.
I need to look.
Not much.
You're right, he's ugly.
How many times did you shoot around?
Once?
Wow. I'm a little embarrassed that you would ask that question, but yes, because I have three shootings. Three, that means that whatever was being shot at is still alive.
Three was in between us somewhere, I think.
Well, what do you think, Ron? What do you have to say about the season so far?
Well, I think that, this doe thinning part of our season has gone very well. We've gotten almost the number of does that the state wanted us to take, but you know, we're seeing a lot of scrapes out there now, and I think it's time that we move into the buck harvest mode.
I think the bucks are starting to get active, you know, this last week of the season,
yeah,
the last
here,
10 days.
Big old scrape right here in the road.
It's always a fun time of the year in Alabama these last 10 days, so we need to get hard, get on it hard and see what we can do. And we've gotten a few management bucks. Now if we can get a couple of good ones for the wall, that would be nice.
We need to stick with our same 8 points or better outside the ears. And of course, we do have that hit list of some management that we've got to.
Bucks, if they happen to stroll by, we'll take care of them too. So.
Well, that's let's call the doe season officially over.
All right, I'm ready.
In the Woods with Ron and Jerry is brought to you by Envirologic of Alabama, products that make sense for you and your environment. By Landis International, there is no substitute for perfection. By NPP Incorporated, flying Ron and Jerry to the next day in the woods. By the 500 Magnum Energy Bar, power for now, power for later. And by Karma LLC, an elevated state of awareness.
Holy, turn the camera on, turn the camera on. Look at this.
We're encouraged, I guess you'd say. Wildlife, domestic wildlife, doesn't get any better than that. Well, it gets better than that. Right now, we'll take whatever we can see out here. Anything living and breathing besides the two of us.